What's up? Welcome back. I'm sorry for this weird ass angle. I have some free time right now and I kind of want to talk to you guys. Hopefully I can fix this angle. And you guys saw this shirt in my last video. Don't think I'm wearing the same shirt. It's not the same shirt. He made me two shirts with my face on it. One is like cut this way and one is cut that way. Just know I got two shirts. Don't think I'm wearing the same shirt. But anyways, I just dropped my necklace off. One of the links on my necklace broke, so it's in the jewelry repair shop right now. He said it's gonna take about 10 minutes, so. But yeah, I wanted to talk to you guys because I feel like I always film stripper vlogs now, and there's like a lot of other content that I wanna show you. But stripper vlogs are really the main thing because that's what I'm really focused on right now. That's like my main goal right now, is to work on these stripper vlogs. But don't worry, there's gonna be other little things here and there. Like, I have to do some business stuff this week and I would like to update you guys on my business and all that good stuff. But yeah, today's video is gonna be all about my first month on the pole. Your girl is okay on the pole right now. I'm not good, I'm not bad, I'm okay on the pole right now. So I started with my pole lessons. I've taken four lessons. I did one full month of lessons and I did one lesson a week. So I took four classes. My first two classes were in Brooklyn with this girl, Candy, and I posted that video already so you guys can see what I learned there. And then I took a class in Atlanta at Pink Pole Studio, and I'll insert the routine that we learned here. I'll put it in. And then I also have done one more pole class with this teacher out here. Her name is Kenny. I love her. She's so sweet. Like, love Kenny. And I took a class with her. I also filmed that, and I'll insert that here as well.
It's sexy. Look at it.
Yeah. Turn everything up a little more.
My experience the first month of pole, it's a lot harder than it looks. Like, it looks like they just grab themselves and just throw themselves around the pole. It's hard. You really have to work out. And one thing that nobody talks about is the bruising. my legs are covered in bruises, like covered. If I was any more light skinned, somebody would think I was getting beat or something. Like my right calf, I pulled the muscle sprained. I pulled it actually at that pull class I did with the girl. We were doing this one trick. It's an inside leg hang and you have to hold yourself up with your calf. My calf pressing against that pole, holding up all of my body weight. Yeah, I was doing a lot. But now it's still sprained, but the feeling is low-key starting to come back. But I kind of messed it up again. I was playing on my friend's pole the other day and I tried to do an outside leg hang with the same leg and the pain shot up to my knee. So I'm like, let me relax with this leg for a little while. So I've been doing more leg hangs with my left leg than my right leg, but I can still do it on both. Anyways, what I've learned so far, you need to stretch before you get on the pole. If you don't stretch before you get on the pole, just say goodbye to your legs, say goodbye to your arms, say goodbye to your body. I did last week, I could do a full split. This week I cannot even get 2 inches towards the ground because I didn't stretch all week. It's just crazy. You really have to stay on your stuff. You really got to stretch. You really got to stay flexible. And then also, I've learned that, like, my endurance is kind of crazy. Like, you think that you can't do something and you keep trying and you're like, oh, this is just, like, whatever. And then you might just need some help, realistically. I was trying to invert for, like, 2 weeks straight and I couldn't do it. It was pissing me off. And I took that one class with Kenny and she showed me what I should do. And now I'm an invert queen. I mean, I can invert upside down with no hands now. I can do it with one hand. Like, I'm getting better. It just feels good. But I really just wanted to talk to you guys about my first month of pole and show you guys where I started, because I'll insert a clip from my... And then, sorry, I forgot to mention, I bought a pole. So I've been practicing at home. So I'm going to insert a clip of my first day at home on the pole. And then I'll insert a clip of me on the pole yesterday so that you can see the actual growth that I've been having on this pole. It's really cool to watch. I worry that I wasted the best in me. Oh, yeah, baby, you don't care. Sometimes trying to be a nuisance, it's just urgent. Trying to make sense of little change, got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go and wake and keep what's holding me. Choose the right, but it will pick up in front of me. All the while, I'll wave my arm and feel it a smile. Still wanna try. Okay, so now that you've seen where I started and where I'm at now, leave an opinion in the comments. Let me know what you think I should work on next at my level, because I'm definitely still a beginner. You can give me any tips for things that you think will help me make better. If you know of any cool, like, what I really want to get good at is flow and transitions. I can do the tricks, but I need to work on my transitions, making it look more fluid, making it look more pretty. So if you guys have any suggestions, please leave them in the comments. And if you have any suggestions for my next video, or if you just want another stripper vlog, let me know. But thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you on my next one. Bye.